It has become Saturday. Welcome to News Dump. Everyone, look, it looks like bad reviews from the stuck-up, holier-than-thou Marvel bankrolled critics.
Eating their arugula and their gray poupon mustard and wearing their tan suits. Thanks, Obama.
Those and all those suburban Midwestern moms bringing their entire families to go see A Star Is Born, starring Lady Gaga and Bradley Cooper.
Live, laugh, love.
They just, those combined, it just wasn't enough to stop people from seeing Venom, because Venom has already broken box office records for October, and by the time this actually airs, it might have broken more.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
October's supposed to be spooky month.
Venom's not terrifying?
I mean, no. What about that scary enough for you? Blah! I got big old teeth.
I got a big tongue. You wanna know what that tongue do? Come see it in the theaters.
Blah. So yeah, maybe it was morbid curiosity and the desire to see something that couldn't possibly be as bad as everyone's saying. Maybe there's just not a whole lot of other big blockbusters out there right now, or hell, maybe people actually really fucking love the character of Venom and just could not wait to check this film out.
There's a big group of people out there like that.
I relate to Venom more than any other hero.
And if you want to see that rated R version of Venom, when I was on the way here, I just saw the headline that they've already released the porn parody called Ven-Cum.
Yeah.
So,
that's cool.
Release the Wood Rocket cut.
They're getting quick with this shit.
Yeah.
It's like SNL over in the porn industry. So yeah, the public perception surrounding Venom definitely seems to have shifted over the past couple days, mostly from what seems a consensus from actual moviegoers that says, just go in with low expectations and have some dumb fun.
It is October after all, the month of dumb fun.
At worst case scenario, it's a great excuse to eat some popcorn and drink a big Coke.
Yeah.
And hey, that's totally fine. Maybe it's the big dumb movie that we need right now.
Yeah, it's a good distraction.
The world is kind of awful.
Yeah.
And maybe I want to look at some guy with some big tongue and weird gooey black skin that he shoots around.
Yeah. It's just what we need. Now, whatever it is, it's off to a great start. It kicked things off this weekend with a $10 million Thursday opening night, which broke the record for highest Thursday gross for a movie in October. Now, for comparison, Justice League did $13 million on its Thursday screening, which is... it's more, but really, like, when you have Superman, yeah, Batman, Wonder Woman all in the same movie.
And everyone's favorite, Cyborg.
and then you have, like, a Venom movie without Spider-Man. It did pretty well. Another comparison would be an actual Marvel movie, which is Ant-Man and the Wasp. That only did $6.5 million on its Thursday opening, and that was during the summertime. So Venom's doing really, really, really well. The movie will, of course, continue to grow as the weekend progresses, and estimates so far say that it will land around $65 million on opening weekend once it's done, I couldn't have seen this coming. I wouldn't have put money on this. I've hit a lot of bets on movie box office openings. I would have guessed $30 million, which is literally fucking half of what it's actually going to make.
Yeah, I guess I was way off with this one.
Yeah, I mean, I'm actually, like, you know what's funny, and people were saying this in the comments too during the Lady Gaga episode, I'm actually more interested in the movie now after the bad reviews than I was before. Because even the bad reviews are like, there's a good movie in there somewhere, and I want to go find that movie.
If we all dig together, there's a good movie in there, and we're all going to find it, and we're going to be rich.
Yeah. Now, sadly, not enough moms brought their kids to see A Star Is Born, because it only got $3.5 million on Thursday, and the estimates for that are putting it around $30 to $40 million during opening weekend, which it's not bad for that movie.
Not bad. Not bad. But hey, let's move on from the weirdest movie war of October 2018 and give you a quick update on a topic that we've been covering for a while. The Fyre Festival and its founder, Billy McFarlane. Bad Billy McFarlane.
The most American white name I've ever heard. And the most American white crime that he could have committed.
Why, that's the good neighbor boy, Billy McFarlane.
Oh, you mean little Billy McFarlane?
That boy would never hurt a fly.
Well, that's as his lawyer says.
Yeah. So now, obviously, as we've found out through the ongoing investigations into McFarlane's past, Fyre Festival was only one of the many scams that he had been running for years, wasting around $25 million from investors. So the court case around him is extremely serious, and he's potentially looking at a very, very long time in the clink.
That's the thing is, just Fyre Festival ripping off a bunch of dumb millennials? Slap on the wrist probably from big government. But ripping off $25 million worth of investors' money who are probably very powerful.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Mr. McFarlane, I was ready to, let you off with a slap on the wrist because those pictures of all those poor rich people stranded
on Earth.
It was hilarious. Me and my family, we gathered around and looked at those pictures of their bread sandwiches.
And we laughed.
And we laughed. But then, come to find out, you've been defrauding investors.
Yeah. You can fuck with people, you just can't fuck with the wrong people.
Yeah.
And that's what he did.
Yeah.
So the latest news is that Billy McFarland, it's a fun name to say.
Oh, Billy McFarland.
Billy McFarland will finally be sentenced next week on October 11th, and prosecutors in the case have asked the judge to sentence him to up to 20 years in prison.
Woo!
His lawyers, however, they're arguing that McFarland suffers from a, quote, untreated mental illness. And they don't mention what that meant. It's just untreated, so it could be anything.
He's just crazy, like Harley Quinn in Suicide Squad. Like, yeah. Is it depression? Is it bipolar disorder?
Yeah, I don't
what
know.
Is it? I guess it's just all of them at different times.
It's old school crazy. Like, yeah. When you look back in history, it was just, you were just crazy.
Yeah.
Maybe. It didn't have a name.
Probably from that reefer.
Yeah.
It gives you the madness.
Mm-hmm. So his lawyer, they're asking the judge to be far more lenient in the sentencing because obviously it's totally not his fault that he defrauded millions of dollars from people over years with an untreated, undiagnosed mental illness.
Forgot to take my medication and whoops.
I defrauded
millions from several investors over multiple years and did an entire sham music festival.
At least was he on Twitter? Did he get racist on Twitter?
I don't know, probably.
His lawyers say that he is redeemable and that he, quote, has a good heart that has been led astray by poor judgment. Is poor judgment a mental illness?
Yeah, also, I guess you know, his heart's good. It's not his heart I'm really worried about, it's his brain.
Yeah,
his brain seems bad.
Yeah, anyways.
Yeah, so that smells like bullshit. And hopefully, he goes away for a long time. And maybe he'll get a job on the party planning committee at the prison.
Jail?
Yeah, and we'll all have a great time.
Yeah.
But hey, we're gonna have to wait till next week to find out for sure.
So stay tuned.
Or, we can just wait for Shane Dawson to release a 10-part YouTube docuseries about him. So that he and his shrink friends can diagnose him for all of us. Is Billy McFarland a sociopath? Spooky music? Yeah, sure, he's a sociopath.
Yeah, whatever.
Boom, views.
Who gives a shit?
Back to movie news, though. Last week, we talked about the very smart idea that Disney had, where they decided that maybe they would slow down a little bit on the whole Star Wars gravy train. Just a little bit. But that was just for the films, I guess, because this week we got some new info from Star Wars TV projects from director Jon Favreau that's being created for Disney's premium streaming service launching next year.
So the show will be called The Mandalorian. And thanks to a post on Favreau's Instagram, we know the basic plot of the show as well. His post reads this. After the stories of Jango and Boba Fett, another warrior emerges in the Star Wars universe.
Does it cover Boba Fett's brother, Jango Fett, with his big old pants?
Yes. Yeah. It is funny though, that like even when they're like, we got a new, fresh, completely original idea. And it's just like, It's
Boba Fett.
It's not Boba Fett. It looks just like Boba Fett, though.
I mean, all anyone really likes about Boba Fett, let's be honest, it's that helmet.
Yeah.
This guy's got the helmet.
And that, well, and it's also the fact that he's kind of mysterious, but this just ruins that.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, it's not about him. Sorry, I get confused looking at the photo, where it's very clearly meant to be geared towards fans of Boba Fett.
Oh, sweet, a Boba Fett show.
Exactly.
Oh, this is weird.
The description continues, The Mandalorian is set after the fall of the Empire and before the emergence of the First Order, but where does it fall with stealing the plans to the Death Star and Han Solo getting his name? Anyways, he says, we follow the travails of a lone gunfighter in the outer reaches of the galaxy, far from the authority of the New Republic. He also posted a photo of the character. Obviously, we've just been talking about it. It just looks like Boba Fett, so
cool.
There you go.
Yeah. I love that helmet.
We all do, don't we?
What a cool helmet.
Yeah, I hear he has rocket boosters.
Hey, what if we made a TV show about the helmet?
That'd be pretty cool.
Your wish is granted.
Yeah.
I'm director Jon Favreau.
Yeah.
Now, as far as any future Star Wars property goes, though, this one does have a lot of potential. Jon Favreau is a fantastic filmmaker, and there's also a ton of other incredible filmmakers who will be joining the project to direct their own episodes, including Dave Filoni, Deborah Chow, Taika Waititi, Rick Famuyiwa, and Bryce Dallas Howard? All right.
I know, right? That's cool.
Yeah.
Very cool.
We've met her. She's a very nice
lady.
She's
very nice.
One of the realest in the biz.
Yeah.
Her
dad's bald.
Yeah, he is. And her uncle is really weird looking. Yes.
Was he in Solo? He had to have been.
He's in everyone. Yeah, I'm sure he probably, they probably put him out there just like, oh wow, look at this weird alien race.
What's his name, Don Howard?
Clint Howard.
Oh.
He seems like a nice
it's
guy
It's me, Ron
too.
Howard. This is my brother, Don Howard.
So, I mean, look, we haven't been too excited for anything Star Wars related recently, but hey, this project has us mildly curious and, you know, hopeful at least. Plus, that helmet. I love that fucking helmet.
I love how we were both just immediately like, you know who's nice? Bryce Dallas Howard, great lady, very friendly. Spent a great day with her in Hawaii for Jurassic World, and then we just immediately dogged her dad and uncle.
Well, it's, you know, got to bring balance to the force out here.
Yeah, perfectly balanced, as all things should be.
Fair and balanced. Yeah. Every compliment must also come with an insult. That's the internet today ethos.
Yeah. Anyways, here's another thing that sounds interesting and hopefully pays off. Ryan Reynolds has signed on to another project with 20th Century Fox, helmed by Sean Levy, called Free Guy. And the premise is that Reynolds will be playing an NPC in a video game who, at some point, apparently realizes that he's living in this virtual world. And then he enlists the aid of an avatar and tries to stop the devs from shutting down the game, thereby, you know, killing his world and everyone in it. We're looking at you, Cliff Bleszinski.
This is literally Wreck-It Ralph. And also Woody Tondorf. Hello, Woody Tondorf. He literally, there's the Machinima, the actual Machinima series NPC that he wrote like 5 years ago that took place in GTA.
This is the exact concept. It's different. Warner Brothers, they lost the rights to that somewhere. And
yeah, sure. Whatever.
Actually, maybe you're onto something. Maybe we could light the fires of a lawsuit here and get this movie shut down.
Get Woody paid. I'll of course take a finder's fee.
Yeah, exactly. And then no one will get to see this movie because we ruined it.
Sorry.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna ruin this movie. Anyways, it's a cool enough, if not completely contrived, premise.
I think it sounds. I mean, don't think about it too hard. It sounds pretty cool.
Yeah, it's a ways away from being made fully. So we're just gonna file it very back in the far reaches of our minds and forget about it until it's made, Red Dead Redemption.
So forget about that. Instead, let's focus on the stuff that's actually coming out sometime in the near future with a look at the trailers from this week, starting with the newest trailer for your favorite franchise, your most anticipated movie, Aquaman, baby!
Aquaman! From director James Wan.
He got a big old spear.
Yeah. Mm. It's got four spikes on it.
He never wears a shirt.
Yeah, it's a quadrant.
So Aquaman, which for some reason is just, this trailer's called an extended video.
That is so weird and strange. Yeah, it's a trailer.
It of course dropped on Friday at New York Comic Con, and it gives us the best look yet at this movie. For now, we're still a bit worried about this, but the trailer definitely gives us at least a little bit more hope for the film because it looks like it's gonna be goofy as hell, in a good way.
Yeah, it's definitely not taking itself serious.
Good, because Aquaman is a patently ridiculous concept. Yeah. So during the parts that need to be somewhat serious here, it looks like Mira steals the show as she leads around Aquaman's dopey ass, trying to get him to actually do some shit.
Yeah, it definitely feels like she's like, God, this fucking guy. All right, listen, you gotta put your fucking sweat in the thing, and then come on, we gotta go fight things. It's like leading him around the entire time.
He's just some sea hunk.
Also, there's a great, the line is going to be mocked ruthlessly. The line where he's like, why didn't we just pee on it? Because they need water for this device, and she takes his sweat, she goes like, blah, blah, and like grabs his sweat with magical powers and then drops his sweat in there. And he's like, why didn't we, you didn't have to be such a show if we could have just peed on it. And like that line would have killed in theaters. Yeah. Like if they had not put that in the trailer, that line would have done really well in theaters.
Yep.
And now it's just gonna be fucking mocked.
Ruined.
Yeah, stop, like, come on, have a little restraint here.
Trailers should be illegal.
Anyways, you get to see more Black Manta and his cronies in this trailer, and they look fucking great.
How does he fit through a door with that big old head?
Donk! I bet it's gonna be a bunch of funny jokes.
He looks like Darth Helmet from
it looks
Spaceballs.
Like a mixture of that and the, like, robot from Power Rangers that just gets nervous the whole time.
And Stewie from Family Guy.
Yeah. And Arnold from Hey Arnold. Yeah, it seems like all the best parts, including Black Manta, they take a place outside of the water.
Good.
So I hope there's plenty more of that. I mean, obviously, we're just seeing 5 minutes here, but hey, Black Manta looks great. There's a scene where Mira is running across rooftops that actually plays out really well and is very James Wan. It's a very James Wan shot. Okay. I appreciated it. So yeah, this whole extended video, it did a good job of making me at least slightly more interested in the film, but I don't give a shit about the villain that lives underwater at all. Keep Aquaman above ground, that's what I say.
Dry him off. Dry that wet man off.
Why would you pee on it?
I mean, like, when he comes out of the water, do you think he, like, Probably pisses his pants still, because like when you're in the ocean, yeah, you just pee your pants. Like, what the fuck are you doing? Why does it smell like piss in here?
Oh,
like,
they show off his full suit, by the way, and this looks
great. I thought you were going to say show off his full penis.
Well, you can see it in the outline, obviously. Mm.
Yeah. So here's another superhero movie that we are actually definitely interested in. Spider-Man Into the Spider-Verse, aka the new animated Spider-Man movie that has a bunch of Spider-Men and Spider-Women in it. A new trailer shows off the awesome animation style once again, and then gives us a deeper dive into the Miles Morales story that we're going to see play out in the film. During his training with Peter Parker, he's joined by other spider people, like Gwen Stacy, Spider-Man Noir, and Spider-Ham, which is a pig version of Spider-Man, played by John Mulaney.
Mulaney. That's Spider-Pig.
Yeah, the movie looks great. It actually looks like a ton of fun. I love everything I've seen so far. I think I'm more excited for this than any superhero movie like since The Dark Knight.
It looks like a blast.
Yeah. So definitely excited to see this when it drops 1 week before Aquaman.
Whoops.
And 1 week before that rebranded Deadpool movie on December 14th.
December 14th. And remember, Aquaman, the 21st. Keep that in mind. Because finally in trailers, we've got the trailer for the upcoming movie about former vice president, an absolute piece of human garbage. Dick Cheney, and that movie's called Vice. It's being directed by Adam McKay, who you definitely know from his comedy films like Anchorman, Step Brothers, and Talladega Nights, but also from his incredible work directing The Big Short.
Yeah.
Obviously, this film is going to be falling a bit more in line with The Big Short, since we'll most likely be laughing and squirming along to some very uncomfortable truths.
Like, man, this is crazy. Wait, what? This all happened?
Wait, this is real?
Fuck. The world is terrible.
Yeah. Vice explores the epic story about how a bureaucratic Washington insider quietly became the most powerful man in the world as vice president to George W. Bush, reshaping the country and the globe in ways that we still feel today. The film stars Christian Bale, who is unrecognizable in his full makeup as Mr. Cheney.
He really fucking
went there.
He went there. Damn.
Yeah. Alongside him is Sam Rockwell, who nails the role of former President George W. Bush. Yeah. I didn't even make that connection mentally until I saw him in the trailer and I was like, wait, what? That's amazing.
Yeah. Yeah, he nailed it. And then Steve Carell as Donald Rumsfeld.
Yeah.
Like, they show him...
Like, but he just looks like his character from Anchorman.
Well, yeah. Young Donald Rumsfeld, yeah, he looks like Brick Tamlin. But when they show him briefly, like, in the Bush administration, and he actually kind of looks like Donald Rumsfeld. I completely forgot this was even being made. This trailer came out of nowhere. I was like, oh shit, this looks incredibly good.
Mm-hmm.
So this, oddly enough, remember we said to remember December 21st? Yeah, it comes out that day too.
Remember the 21st of December.
Yeah, so looks like I'm spending all of Christmas week in a movie theater.
Yeah, but I'm definitely seeing Vice first.
Yeah,
that is highest on my list. Well, I'll see Spider-Man first because it comes out a week earlier.
Yeah.
But yeah, I'm not, you know what? I'll make it a nice double feature, Vice and then Aquaman. As a nice digesty. Wow, that was horrifying. I need to take my mind off of this soul-crushing reality with some absolute fucking bullshit.
Yeah.
So that's a good way to see it.
Yeah.
Anyways, watch the latest episode of Weekly Weird News because, as you can imagine, it's very strange. In mm-hmm. a week that was very strange. So it's pretty much the pinnacle of this entire fucking week. And then also watch the episode if you're more interested in the Venom versus Lady Gaga fucking saga on Twitter. Check out that episode as well. We'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.